Hello video editors, thanks for watching StoryShim. If you use background music in your videos, like I do, then you probably have the same problem that I had. And that is that almost all the music tracks are too long or too short. The method that I used before is to copy the tracks, then find a point where I can cut both tracks, and then glue them together and add something like a fade transition. This does work, but recently I learned a much better method by combining the forces of Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe Audition. So in this tutorial you will learn all about this new method, which will probably sound better and also save you some time. And speaking about time, this tutorial is brought to you by Tex. They made this awesome dark metal lens watch that was inspired by the look of vintage camera lenses. It features a skeleton watch back and it has a fisheye layered sapphire glass, which will remind you of the look of camera lenses. Follow the link in the video description if you want to learn more about this watch inspired by vintage camera lenses. Okay, now it's time to move over to Premiere and start some editing. Inside Premiere, I've got the intro of this tutorial on the timeline. And let's say that I want to use this track as background music. As you can see, the track is way too long. It should end somewhere here, around 1 minute and 3 seconds. So let's keep that in mind and head over to Adobe Audition. And to do this, right-click on the audio track and then select Edit Clip in Adobe Audition. If you select this, then Adobe Audition will be opened automatically. But that's only if you have Adobe Audition installed, of course. Okay, inside Adobe Audition, we want to turn this into a multi-track session. We can do this by clicking here. This will open up a new window where you can give a name to the new session. I will just name this one Background Music and then click OK. Here, inside the Files panel, you can find the session file that we just created and also the track that we imported into Adobe Audition. We can now drag this song over to the first track in the editor. Okay, here you can see the entire track with the duration of about 2 minutes and 5 seconds. It is the same track that you've heard in the background playing so far throughout the entire video. Okay, and now we're going to make this longer or shorter with the remix function inside Adobe Audition. And you can find this here in the Properties panel, and then you need to go to the Remix tab. And there you need to click on Enable Remix. Audition will now start analyzing the track, and depending on your hardware, this shouldn't take longer than 20 seconds. Okay, and once it's done processing, you can change the length of the audio track into any desired duration inside the Remix tab. We'll start with doubling the duration and set it to 4 minutes and 4 seconds. And just like that, Audition changed the 2-minute track into a 4-minute track. If you zoom in on the timeline, you can see where Audition made the stitches. Let's give it a quick playback to see how well Audition remixed the track. I'm sure you really won't notice this when it's playing in the background. And here is the second cut, let's have a listen. Okay, so that works perfectly for this track. But what if you want to make it shorter? Well, to do that, we can also simply change the duration inside the Remix tab. Let's say 1 minute and 4 seconds, which should be fine for our project. And there you go, it's now a track of 1 minute and 4 seconds. And if I zoom in, you can see that the cut was made here. Let's have a listen. And again, a very good remix. I'm sure you won't hear the difference when it's playing in the background. Now we've only got one step left, and that is exporting the track to be used inside Premiere Pro. To do this, you need to go to File, then select Export and select Export to Adobe Premiere Pro. In the window that pops up, you can change the name and you can select a location for the export. Make sure that the option to open it in Adobe Premiere is selected and click Export. It will then go back to Premiere, and for the option to copy to Active Sequence, you need to select New Audio Track. And here we've got the shorter version of the background music on a new track. We can just remove the longer version and keep the new one. Now the duration of the background music matches perfectly with our project. Okay, to be fair, this track was perfect for this scenario. In my tests, all the tracks without vocals had a very good result. But tracks with vocals sometimes gives a mixed result. Take this one for example. The original version is about 4 minutes long. And I've doubled that to about 8 minutes. And this is the first cut point including vocals. That didn't sound too good, but let's have a listen at the second point. And that one did sound a lot better, especially if you only use this for background music. Anyway, it's time for you to start testing this on your own music, and please feel free to share the results in the comments below. And that also concludes this Premiere Pro and Audition tutorial. If you want to see more tutorials, then check out one of these two. Anyway, as always, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.